What's going on, guys? Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. My name is Moose78. Hope you guys are having a great day today. And we are here in Tucson, Arizona, back in the Mac Pinnacle, the updated Mac Pinnacle. Pretty sure this is going to be released here pretty soon. Thanks to Robert for sharing this with some folks to kind of test it out, check it out. Done an amazing job on this, done a lot of work to it. You guys are going to absolutely love this thing. But let's hop out, take a look at it. And you can kind of see we are specced out for some heavy haul today. You see that big old sumbitch back there? That's what we're going to be hauling today. Big old bucket going up to Kayenta. I think that's how you pronounce it. Probably butchered it, but Kayenta, Arizona. So we got our beacons on. We got our oversized load on. But before we get started today, just wanted to give you guys a huge thank you. Passed another milestone on the channel. We are over 900 subs now. So thank you guys so much for your continued support. And if you really want to help continue to support the channel, do me a huge favor, like and share the videos, because that just helps the channel get some more exposure, helps the videos get some more exposure, and it helps the interaction on the channel, obviously, which YouTube sees that. They kind of see the video a little bit higher. So it just helps a ton when you guys do that. But thank you so much for your continued support. But let's go ahead and fire this thing up. I'm trying to remember the name of it. The MP610, 510, I can't remember. It's the 605 horsepower engine, the biggest engine you can have in this. So I figured since we're hauling this big old bucket behind us, wanted to have a big engine in it. Where it's got the Eatonfuller 18 speed. And the reason why I go with the 18 speeds all the time is that's just how I have the game set up. So I can use it with the SKRS. I don't have to worry about changing shift patterns from, you know, an 18 speed to a 13 speed to something else. Now you see there is a lift axle on this, and we'll kind of show that off here in a second. Lined up with this thing back here. Watch the lift axle. This is pretty cool. Lift axle works. That's the first truck, or this is the first truck I've used that actually has an operating lift axle or a functional lift axle, so pretty cool. We got our beacons turned on. Brakes are working good. Now this is fast becoming one of my favorite trucks in the game. Rob's done an amazing job on this. Looks great, sounds great. Thing's definitely gonna be a lot of fun to use. That is for sure. Gonna try to keep this pretty realistic. I think it's around noon. Just actually take a look here. Yeah, it's 1 p.m. in the game, so we're only gonna operate this big old hog beast during the daytime. Cleared back there, so that's good. Rip any doors off. The car is gonna stop. This thing would chew that thing up and spit it right back out. Undoubtedly, this is the biggest thing I've hauled in game, so this should be a lot of fun. What? Okay, I thought I killed it. Guess not. Thank you. want to get back and finish up some of the old school stuff that I started last week. I got the 521 now, the Kenworth 521. I want to use that for a couple episodes. Of course, get the 680 back on here, use that a little bit more. The W900. I got some gameplay footage of the 389 that I still need to edit and get that up. A pretty good run from Reno to Eureka, California. Nice scenic run. We have two lanes and up through the mountains and everything. So I think you guys will enjoy that. And then I know I keep talking about it, but I finally started to reinstall LSPDFR. So I want to get that finished up this week and start to get that back up on the channel. This kind of breaks up the monotony for at least me to do some different content besides ATS. Then hopefully tomorrow, kind of see how everything goes, but I'd like to do a live stream over on YouTube of some ATS as well. Probably around, start probably about 10 o'clock in the morning, probably go to about noon or so, just a couple hours. Then this weekend, probably starting Thursday there. Be streaming over on Twitch TV, which my link for that is down in the video description, so be sure to check that out, because I will stream ATS over there as well. But gonna be streaming the Ghost Recon's Wildlands open beta this weekend, so be sure to tune in and check that out. Be a lot of fun. Kind of crazy, cars can't even get around this thing. It's kind of large. It's up here. That always gets me. I think I need to turn there, but it's right here where I need to turn. On so we can hop out here on the interstate. I might want to get over there, Chief. I really do like the engine sounds on this though. Sounds really, really good. Coming, so we're just gonna coast through there. That is pretty cool looking back there and seeing that big bucket though. I think I will most definitely be using this thing for some heavy haul stuff here in the future as well. I know from time to time you guys hit me up about some heavy haul stuff, so I think this will be my dedicated heavy haul rig. I have to work up a little skin for it, get the old JK Trucking logo on there. soon. I absolutely will. Don't worry, guys. I will definitely get back down into Mexico later on this week. Just I seen this was updated today, so I wanted to break it out and use it and kind of use it for some heavy haul stuff. So I don't do a lot of heavy haul stuff. I, you know, pretty much stick to kind of your standard kind of freight hauler stuff, you know, dry vans, reefers, stuff like that. That looks freaking cool. Got the drop axle going. In here. Don't run anyone over. Might just stick behind this flatbed here for a little bit. San Pedro River. One thing I like about the modding community for this game is they come out with some pretty cool stuff, some pretty unique stuff that we never get from the developer. You know, the heavy haulage and all that good stuff. Use this a couple times this week though. Like I said, I want to get the 680 back out and kind of use that a little bit maybe. Definitely want to use the W900 again. Like I said, already got some stuff with 389 for this week. Want to use the 521, get some old school trucking back up. I'm always keeping my eyes peeled on the Steam Workshop and a couple of the other mod sites and stuff out there for some new trucks and stuff like that. Kind of keep things fresh on the channel. I did see there was an updated version of Freightliner FLB out there. Looks like they kind of cleaned up a little bit, some new textures and stuff like that on the interior. So don't mind to check that out. Thankfully, there's nothing coming through here. Holy cow. Kind of thought there was a turn coming up here. Thank you. This must be one of the new cities of MHA. We still got a pretty good distance to go. So this will definitely be a two-parter, that'll be nice. Just a little bit more heavy haul action up on the channel. Back to the two-lane and we go. And hoping this time I also get a little bit of time to sit down and get some modding done as well. I have not sat down with a Z modeler for a couple weeks. So no updates on the 680, nothing on the W9. Nothing. Just been a little bit crazy. That's okay. Just wanted to make sure I was my trailer was my lane there, so I wasn't smacking any traffic. But there's tons of stuff that I still want to get done. Some things that I still want to get in game converted over from some older mods from Haulin, stuff like that. Keep forgetting about it, but I gotta see if I still have a copy of it. But there was I think it was for Extreme Trucker or Extreme Trucker 2 maybe, or one of the map mods that Corby did there back in the day, that Western trailer. Mind to get that in game. I think that looked pretty good. An ATS. Nice little windy stretch of highway. Also got a Mac side kit that I wouldn't mind to get in game as well. It's just, finding the time to sit down and do that stuff. Converting the stuff over isn't incredibly complicated. Just takes just a little bit of time. Yeah, hopefully this week can get back into kind of the schedule there, get some uploads up every day. Last week or the week before, said I was getting a little bit burnout, but don't worry guys, I'm not going anywhere, I'm not gonna stop doing this. This is a hobby that I do enjoy doing. Just sometimes it gets a little bit grindy. We'll try to do five videos a week on a game like this where there's a lot of content out there, thanks to the modding community. There's, the rescale, like I said, the rescale definitely helps, but I think once I get LSPDFR back up on the channel, and then also mixing in some live streams and stuff like that, I think that'll kind of help break up the monotony for me a little bit. Wouldn't mind, kind of see how it goes, but wouldn't mind to get maybe some of, Ghost Recon's up on the channel as well, kind of see how that goes. Maybe I should check my mirrors a little bit more often. Oopsie. Grab a screenshot here as I drive all over the road. That's pretty awesome. That's why I don't get outside of the interior view that much, because I just get all squirrely. And there. Fucker. primarily you guys are here for the ATS content, and that's primarily what I'm here to do, so that kind of works out for both of us, I guess. Yeah, I'm excited for Ghost Recons, though. Played the closed beta, that was a lot of fun, even though the performance absolutely sucked on PC. I think it's still going to be a fun game. So it'll be nice to get some co-op in with some of the guys on that. And also do the solo stuff on it, too. That's one of the things I really like about The Division. I mean, there's tons of options. You know, you can have the solo experience, the single player experience, you can have the co-op experience, you can have the PvP experience, especially with 1.6 coming up here pretty soon with Last Stand, you know, dedicated PvP. That's going to be a lot of fun. I want to get into that. So I might from time to time start posting some different content up on the channel. But like I've always said, the primary focus is always going to be truck sims. So that's got me almost 1,000 subs, so I want to stay true to that. Oh, this is definitely a hobby I like, that I like. I enjoy it. Awesome part of the map up here. I really like how there is a GPS option for the back here now. This helps everything look a little bit cleaner. That way you don't have to have you know, that up all the time. Actually, I need to bring that back up real quick. What time is it? Yeah, it's about 6:30 going on 7 o'clock here in game. So yeah, probably need to start looking for a place to shut her down for the day. This is something obviously you wouldn't transport overnight. You'd have to, you know, do this stuff during the day. Like, we're splitting back out to the four lane here. Actually, I'm gonna bring up map here rightly quick. We're coming up on Sholo. Yeah, so there'll be some options here in Sholo to stop and catch a break. Let's see, we want to go all the way down here, probably. Since we'll just mark that there. Yeah, the interior on this thing is looking pretty smart nowadays. You know, not that it really wasn't before, but you got a couple different options for the interior. And damn it. Get on the brakes there a little bit hard. I'm looking down at the floor. Not paying attention to what's going on. Turn that guy off. Yeah, this, I gotta say, this is a pretty damn cool combo. I typically don't get into the heavy haul stuff a whole lot, just nothing against or anything like that. I think a lot of it looks really good, looks really cool. But I just never get into it a whole lot. But man, I am digging this combo. I am. Where's the motel? That's pretty cool. I don't know if I've ever seen that before. Was that? That's just a placeholder, I think, because I don't see anywhere where I could get this big old hog beast in there and park. Is this? Okay, this is Sholo. So I don't know if this must be some edits that MHA did to Sholo, because I don't remember Sholo ever looking this cool. Where, let's see, is that up on the left-hand side? Maybe, I can't really tell. Looks like, looking at the HUD there, it looks like it should be just right up here at this intersection. No easy way for me to get over there right now. I'll force my way over, I guess. Be too bad to get this thing in there. Should not be too bad at all. Nothing's coming, so we'll just kind of breeze on through the stop sign there. And we'll get it hung up, of course. I don't always do a heavy haul, but when I do, I usually screw something up. Alright, well, I'm gonna get this big ol' hog beast parked. And we will pick it up here in Sholo next episode, and we should be able to finish up the run. Well, maybe not. Might go three, but yeah, we should be able to finish it up going from Sholo up to Kayenta next episode. So guys, if you liked today's video, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. Guys, until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing ya.